ಲ್ಯಾಬ್ ಇದೆಯಮ್ಮ ಬೇಡ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಮಾಡಿ. Yeah, can anyone say how many programs you have done in the lab? How many programs is got over in the lab session?
Four completed,
right? Yeah. Today we'll complete with the fifth one, and that will be end of your lab session from my side. But you people have to practice, and some of you have shown, and some of you have not shown the execution of your lab programs. Maybe from next week you have to. We may not have the online classes. We will be having the offline classes. That's what. So I just want to complete everything by today, and from next week we'll do revision. Okay. So next, that is 11:10:50. What we'll do is we'll have. You have to show me fourth program. Some people have not shown me the fourth program, right? People who have not shown fourth program, you have to show me the fourth program in the next lab. I've just marked here who have not shown also.
Ma'am, can you call out their names, ma'am, so that we know?
Fourth program. Yeah, next after this, I'll just explain it, because 1 hour is required for me for the fifth program. Okay, so now we start with the fifth program. Fifth and last program.
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಫುಲ್ಲಿ.
ಓಕೆ, ನೌ ಯು ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ, ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಲಿಸನ್? ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ ಈಗ?
ಯಾ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. ಯಾ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಫೈನ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್? ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ?
ಎಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಎಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಟುಡೇ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಸೈನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಯರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ಫೈವ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಾ ಇಯರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್. ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ಸಿನಾರಿಯೋ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್. ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಸ್ಕೀಮಾ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟೇಬಲ್ ನೇಮ್, ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಕಾಲಮ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್. ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದ ಸಿನಾರಿಯೋ. ಸೊ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್, ಬಟ್ ದೇ ವಾಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಾ ಅ ಇಯರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ಫೈವ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಾ ದ ಇಯರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ರಿಲೇಷನಲ್ ಮಾಡೆಲ್, ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅ ಸೂಟಬಲ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಕ್ವೆರೀಸ್. So what the fifth program says to us is a country wants to conduct an election for the parliament. So what is this scenario says to us? The scenario speaks about the election team. So how the election is been conducted in the parliament, how they have to organize in any country. Let us take India. So in India, they want to conduct a election for parliament. And a country having many constituency, how many constituencies we'll be having? We'll be having many constituency. Each constituency is identified uniquely by constituency ID. So now Karnataka is, let us assume that each state is being given with one constituency. Like we have a Karnataka, we have in South India there are four states, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, now it is five, right? So now again Andhra has been divided into two, Andhra and Telangana, then Tamil Nadu, then Kerala. So like this, each one of them will be having a constituency IDs. And what should be there in that constituency? They have told that you should have a name, a state, number of voters. How many people are there in India, in Karnataka, and which state it is belonging. The state is Karnataka, name of the state is Karnataka, and what is the constituency number? Some number we are giving. So in the same way, number of people, how many people are eligible to give a vote? So number of people we have to count. then constituency can have many voters. So how many voters each again in Karnataka, again if we divide it in Karnataka, again there are so many district places. So now if we consider Bangalore is one district, again in Bangalore there are so many subdivisions in that. Maybe Yelahanka, north part, south. So like this, there are so many things. So that's what here we can see. Each voter is uniquely identified using a voter ID. I hope so. If you are more than 18 years, then definitely you'll be having your voter ID. And in voter ID, what you should have, you'll be having the name, age, and the address. Means what is your name? What is age? Because the person less than 18 is not eligible to vote. Only the person who is above 18 have a right to give a vote. So that's the reason, name, age, and the address. And in address, what they want? House number, city, state, and pin code. Then each voter belongs to only one constituency. So you cannot have two voter IDs, one in Bangalore, one in some other place. No, each one will be having only one. There are many candidate contesting in the election. There may be so many people. One may be from BJP, one may be from Congress, one may be from JDS. There may be so many candidates who are contesting for the election. Then each candidate are uniquely identified using a candidate key. And each of them will be given a unique ID. So 1, 2, 3 numbers will be given. That's what the candidate ID will be given. Along with that, they'll be having their name, their phone number, their age, and the state. For which state this particular person has been voting. A candidate belongs to only one party. So that's what one candidate for one party will be given an option. There may be many parties. So like that, you may have a BJP, you may have a Congress, you may have JDS, you may have independent. Like this, there may be so many parties. Each party is uniquely identified by using a party ID, having a party name, party symbol. So along with that, you have a party ID uniquely identified, party name like BJP, party symbol. What is the symbol of BJP? It's lotus. So the same way, what is a party name for other parties? Congress is one, and symbol is what? Hand. So like this, we have so many symbols for each of them. A candidate can contest from many constituency under the same party. A party can maybe party can have many candidates. Now Bangalore, in Bangalore also there are so many districts. Each district will be having each candidate from each party. So like that, the number of constituency having candidates from the same party. A constituency can have many contesting candidate belong to different parties. Each voter only one candidate of his constituency. So we can vote only for one particular candidate. So in this case, what the queries they have asked us to do is list the details of candidate who are contesting from more than one constituency which are belonging to different states. Then display the state name having maximum number of constituency. Then create a stored procedure to insert the tuples into the voter table by checking the voter age. So we have to create a stored procedure where the voter age should be greater than 18. Then you have to display whether if his age is less than 18, then we have to display it is not eligible. If he is okay, then we should insert the values. Then one more create procedure we have to do to display the number of voters in a specified constituency where constituency name is passed on the argument. Then last one is we are creating a trigger to update the count of number of voters of our respective constituents. So to do this, we are creating some tables. So we are creating a table called as a constituency. This is one table constituency. In this table name is a constituency, and column in that is a constitution ID. What is the data type we are taking? We are taking it as a number. What is the size? We are taking the size as 20. Then we have a key called as a primary key. One second. Okay. So in this case, which one is primary key? Constitution, constituency ID is a primary key, and constituency name, data type we have taken, it is a where care, and the size is 20. Then state of the constituency, which state it is, whether Karnataka, Andhra, whichever it is, and number of voters in that particular constituency. Then create table, which party it is, there will be different parties and party ID. So here in party table, party ID is a primary key. What's a party name? What is a symbol? So then create a candidate tables. How many candidates are there? Then the number, primary key, phone number, age, state, name, then PID, then party ID. So we are making it as a foreign key here. Then table, contestant, constitution ID, reference constitution, constitution ID, candidate ID, that is reference candidate ID, then party ID, which has been referred from a party table. So in the same way, voter ID is a primary key, voter name, voter age, address, and for which constituency he is voting, and a candidate ID. So these are the things which are, 1 second. Okay, so here in this case, create table, voter ID, VID, number, primary key, age, all these. So then the same way, insert all the values into this. Let us see what are the tables we have created. So we have already created tables in this. First table is what? First table is constituency. So let us describe how to see the table. Constituency. C-U-E-N-C-Y. Yes. So in the constituency table, ID, name, state, number of voters. Next one, party. Yes, PID, P name, and symbol. So this is what is party table is there. Then candidate key, candidate table, C-A-N-D-I-D-A-T-E-S, candidates, yeah. So the candidate table, candidate ID, phone number, age, state, name, and the ID. And next table. Next one, candidate contest, C-O-N-T-E-S-T. Describe contest. Then describe voter. So these are the tables which has been done. Okay, so I think you are able to see. So what are the tables we have? First table was constituency. Second table was contest. Next table was voter. Next table was voter is over, which is one more table. Constituency, voter, contest. So all these we have seen. Okay, now let us see whether the values, how to insert a value. We have an insert command. Same way you insert the values into the table. Insert into constituency value, the values what you want to insert. So let us see, because already I have inserted, select star from constituency. See, first let me see contest. Okay, so this table is created. Select star from voter. Yes, you can see all these values are already there. Then select star from which table? at the other table, voter is our contest candidate. C A N D I D A T E S is there, right? Candidates. Spelling is mistake. Always we have to take care of the spellings. Select star from candidates. Yes, your candidate table, we have some values. Next one is party. Select star from party. Party spelling P-A-R-T-Y. T-Y. Yes, so the party we have created. And the first one was constituency. Select star from constituency. So these are, you can add, I have just added for my convenience these values. So now what we have done, with creation and insertion of the tables. Next we move on to the query. What is the first query? List the details of candidate who are contesting from more than one constituency which are belonging to different state. So what we want, let me first execute. Yeah. Say, so what they want, list the candidates who are, what is the question there? List the details of candidates. All the candidates they want, but who are contesting from more than one constituency. So I am the candidate. I am in Bangalore. So Bangalore North also I am contestants. Candidates may be in, now let us say in Bangalore North also one candidate is there. Same candidate is there in south of Bangalore also. Then that particular person name we want. List the details of candidate who are contesting from more than one constituency which are belong to different state. Maybe let us assume that because they've told different state, maybe in Karnataka also he is contesting and even in Andhra also he is contesting. So that particular person's details we want. So that's what we have just executed the query. So the candidate is 122 and the phone number is something and the age is 24, the state from where, Karnataka, and name and party ID, 877 is a party. So this is what the first query is being executed. Okay, so next query, display the state name having maximum number of constituency. Which state is having maximum number of districts or maximum number of district places or constituency? So that's what they want here. So here the maximum number of constituencies are in Kerala and Karnataka. It is not true, but we have just entered in the database. Those are I'm fetching. That's what Kerala and Karnataka. Before we move on to the procedures, let me first complete triggers. Then we'll come back to the procedures. So what is a trigger? Trigger is similar like your table, but here we are using a trigger. They have told in the question also, they have told create a trigger to update the count of number of voters of the respective constituency in constituency table after inserting a tuple into the voters table. So here, so what we are doing, same way how we are creating, same way here also we are creating the trigger. So for triggers and procedures, to end that we have to press a slash. So what is the ending of the procedure and trigger is, once you type all your complete command, then to end that you have to press a slash, then only it will come out. So you can see trigger is created. Then what is there in the trigger we need to know. Yes, so I just want to insert some values into the trigger. Yes, because this is already created. Let me create, insert the voter. I'll create one because Nagesh is already there. So I'll give some name. Rama. Age, I'll give 40. I'll give instead of Mandya, I'll give Mysore. And candidate name, I'll change it to 111, I think, right? It is there. Yeah, this one I can change it to 141. Yeah, I want to insert. Now I have created, I just want to insert to the voter using the create. What it is saying, parent key. There is some problem. I cannot give voter ID because 351 may be already there. So in that case, let me select. Because we need to know, no, when I'm entering, if already some same value, primary key is there, definitely it will not take voters only, no? Yeah. Yeah, you can see 346, 341, 121, 121. Yeah. So let me insert. What is the primary key in the voter table? Come back and check the voter table. So voter table primary key is VID. Then constituents ID is referred under constituent, so then that should also be unique. Then candidate is referred from the candidate ID, means which is already present, we have to take them. So here, voter ID I can change and voter name I will change. And rest of them, let me make it same. And this age also I can change to 40. Okay, so let me type it same, paste it there. Yeah, you can see one row is created. What was the problem is because 350 is already there, I cannot give the same because voter ID is a primary key here. I have to change this. Along with that, the last two are foreign keys. It is taken from the constituents. The constituents should be same. If it is different, then it will give us a parent key not found. The same way last also, it is also a foreign key taken from some other table. So this also should be same. Okay. So this is about a third one. So now let me see. Select the constituency. And check out. So these are the constituency, that is that's what I was changing this word, 111 to something. No, I cannot. I have to give only these two. 111 and 222 only should I have to give constituency. That is what present in the table. So now see in the voter ID, because we have inserted 351. Yeah, 351 is there, Ram 40, Mandya 111 and 121. So that then we can say the trigger is executed. Yeah, next one, we move to a procedure. So what is a procedure? Procedure also same as your functions, what we are doing. So we can just check out how the procedure is. That's what, for any of your procedures, once you want to come out, you have to give a slash. Then you can see, procedure created. So then execute, for executing the procedure, before that you have to say set server output on. We have to on this for procedures. So because we are saying that the procedure should be on. Okay, then there are two ways of executing the procedure. One is you can use exe, the procedure name. In our case, it is a age checking. C-H-E-C-K-I-N-G. Yeah, this is one way of executing. Either you can use execute the procedure name. What is the procedure name we have taken? So here in this case, create or replace the procedure. This is a syntax. Age checking, we can give any age, and what they have told in the query is we want to check whether the voters in our table is greater than 18 years. So that's what here, in that case, voter ID, voter age, then begin. If age, that is age should be greater than 8, then only insert into the voter ID and age. Else display age is not, it should be high. Means if you enter age is less than 10, less than 18, then it should say you should enter more than that. So that's how you have to execute. That is a execute age checking. Or one more way of executing is, so you can use begin and give your function name. So what is the function name we have taken? We have taken it as a age checking, then end. Sorry, I missed the ending of line. So you have to give a ending line. So then end. That's what there is a missing there. Symbol encountered a end was expecting the following. Begin age checking end. Okay, because there is some problem. So that's what here. This is a way you have to execute the procedure. And the last one more, they have told create a stored procedure to display the number of voters in the specified constituency where the constituency name is passed as on the argument to store. So what we have to do? So we are creating the display count because we want to know how many people are present in the constituency. Yes, procedure created, then execute exec and procedure name. So before that, what you have to do? Set server output on. Okay, then exe your procedure name. What is the procedure name? Display count. Yes, yeah, maybe some problem with the thing. So this is how you have to execute your procedures in your program. Yes, so this is about your fifth program. And next, the ER diagram. So what are the tables we have? We have a constituency ID, constituency, candidate, voter, party, and contest. So again, in constituency, constituency ID, name, age, number of voters. So in the same way, candidate ID, name, phone number, age, state, PID is one more. Then voter ID, name, age, address, constitution ID, and candidate ID. Then next one is party ID, PID, P name, and a symbol. Then contest ID, candidate. And check out where is the primary keys, which are the primary key. We can see the underlined one is a primary key. So this is a primary key. Constitution ID is a primary key for constitution table. Candidate ID is a primary key for a candidate table. Voter ID is a primary key for voter table. Party ID is a primary key in a party table. Contestant, here there is no primary key, but both are the super keys. Both are fetched from a two different tables. One is constituency ID and another one from a candidate ID. And you can see all these lines represents that which is foreign key and which is primary key. So that's about your fifth program. Yeah. So we can move to W3 School SQL. I just want you people to show us another a stored procedure. So you can see what is a stored procedure. Stored procedure, what is a stored procedure? Stored procedure is a prepared SQL code that can, why do we require a stored procedure? It is like same as a function, where the same function should be used and should be created, and with that function name you can call any number of times. You can save, so the code can be reused over again and again. So if you have any SQL query that you will write over and over again, save it as a stored procedure and then just call it to execute it. So you can also pass the parameters to store. So there are two different ways. The first one is create procedure, what the procedure name you want to create as SQL statement go. This is a syntax for creating a procedure. Then how to execute, exec the procedure name. So that's how you have to execute. So now suppose let us see the demo of the database, the customer table. So we have a customer table. In this we have a customer ID, customer name, customer name is there, address, city, postal and country. So this is the table which is there. So for this table we want to create a customer procedure. So create procedure, select all customer as select star from customer go. So then we are executing the stored procedure name is what? Select all customer. So select all customer. This is what, there is no parameters in this procedure. We have just given only the procedure name and there we are not passing any parameters. Still we have an option for a stored procedure with different parameters. It is not that you have to pass only. Let us see first one, how to pass one parameter. So create procedure, select customer, same procedure, but here how many parameters we are passing? We are passing one parameter, that is a city. So in this case, select star from city from customer where city is equal to city. Then how to execute that? Execute select all customer, what you want? We want from a London. So in the same way, this was for only one parameter, but even we can pass multiple parameters. Now we will pass a city and the postal code. So now we are passing two parameters. So create procedure, select all customer at city and postal where we want this. Let us execute them. So this is how we are executing. SQL comments, no.
Ma'am?
Yes, yes, Purthi.
Ma'am, could you please explain once again the fifth program, that is procedure and triggers? The thing is, we are getting error, right, ma'am? But why? I'm just asking about that. We can rectify, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm doing is. That's the reason I have just explained, because my laptop version is different and my code is different. So that's what I am planning to come. Once you come back, let me explain again. But right now, let me do it because you can prepare everything and come. That's the reason I'm explaining you the procedure again. Okay, so here you want me to explain the trigger. I'll explain the trigger because compatibility with my laptop, it is fine. But in the lab system, it is working. Because in the lab, again, we don't have this webcam and sound thing. So that's why I've just tried like this. Okay, so let me come back. Fifth one, let me explain first. So what we are doing in a trigger is, trigger is similar like our database tables. But what we are saying is, there is a syntax for even creating it. So create or replace. So if suppose now, if table is already there, let me say author is already there, and you are creating same author again, what the SQL will give us? So it will say that the table is already there. So to avoid that, there is one more option called as a create or replace. So what we are doing, we are creating as well as, in case if it is already, the name is already existing with the name count, replace that. That's what the meaning of create or replace trigger. Name of the trigger is count. In case if count is already there in your system, please replace that with the same name as a count. After you create this count, insert on outer. What we want to insert into the outer, for each row, how many rows I want, I can insert. So there is a format for that. Begin. What I want to change in the outer, I want to update the constituency. Then what I want to update the constituency, set number of voters. So now I want to count how many voters are there. How many voters are there? Maybe 4, maybe 5. Day by day it can increase. So we are adding that. That's the reason we are creating the trigger for counting. Counting number of voters in each constituency. Let me take an example. Now we are in Bangalore. Which part of Bangalore we are? We are in a North Bangalore. In North Bangalore, where we are? Yelahanka. So what is the constituency in the Yelahanka? There will be some name. How many people are there? How many voters are there in this constituency? You have to track. For that, we are using this trigger. Where constituency ID equal to new constituency ID. We are just checking out and counting them. So that's the reason you can see if I execute the same again in the this one, it is creating, but it is not saying it's already exist. What is the reason is because we are using the create or replace. Because count just now I have created again. Even though I create, we are saying if it is there, please replace it. Yes. So this is how what this trigger we are using. We are just using this trigger to count number of people, number of voters in particular constituency. That's what here this counting this trigger is being done. So now you can see once we execute for any either procedure or trigger, to end that we have to say slash. Is getting? So to end the trigger or procedure, we have to end a slash. So then you'll say that trigger created. Yes. Then I just want to know, I want to add, because let me say in order how many people were there. Can anyone check how many people, because we are checking how many people are there, how many voters are there, right? Select star from voter. So this is a voter table, right? So in voter table, how many are there? How many voters are there? 6 rows means what? Default 6 people are there. Yes. So already 6 people are there. Now I will insert one more. And I'll give some name, some Asha, and I will insert here. What I'm doing? I'm just inserting one more voter. Already 6 was there. Now which voter I'm adding? One more voter with 352. So now one more row is created. But now what we want? We want how many constituency, how many voters are there? So in where we have changed it, we have changed in the voter table, right? Yes or no? Can anyone respond? How many voters are there? 6 were there. 6 voters were there. I've added one more voter into the voter table. Now add, check out how many I should get now. How many voters are there right now? So that's what here, the number of voters is added to 7. Earlier it was 6. I have inserted one more voter, one row inserted. Now I am checking out whether there are number of voters in that, that is the 111 is a constituency. The name of the constituency is Rajaji Nagar and state is Karnataka. Number of voters earlier were 6. I have added 1. So total is 7. You can add for Kerala also. Let me add for Kerala. So what I'll do is, I will copy this. And you should know what is a voter ID. So voter ID 352 is already there. I have to add 353. Then some name. Then some age. Age is not required. A first of these. Then Mysore, no, in Kerala, some name, Trichy. Which is there in Kerala?
Coimbatore.
Coimbatore, okay, some Coimbatore. Okay. Kerala and Coimbatore diyappa gottilla na, I am not aware of it. Okay. Now constituency, what I have to give?
You want, they don't know.
Oh, ma'am.
Constituency 2, 2, 2.
Ma'am, it's Tamil Nadu, ma'am.
Ah, that's what, see. That's what I told.
Coimbatore in Tamil Nadu, ma'am.
Yeah. That's what I told. Which, can anyone say Kerala's? Kerala?
Munnar.
Munnar, okay. Munnar. Okay, and you, we have to see what is the constituency for Kerala. Kerala constituency ID is what? 222. Okay. Then, what is this last? 212121? I think some candidate name. Candidate name or what? This we have to check it out. Then execute this. One row created. So now again run with the constituency. What I have to get? What I have to get now? If I execute the constituency, you can see the Kerala is updated with 2. Earlier it was with 1. ಹೌದಲ್ವಾ, ಎಲ್ಲೋಯ್ತು. ಹಾ, 222 ಕೇರಳ, ಸಮ್ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಕೇರಳ, ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ 1, ನೌ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 2. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಎ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೌಂಟ್ಸ್, ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ವೋಟರ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇರಳ, ಇನ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ, ಇನ್ ರಾಜಾಜಿನಗರ್. ದ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯುಯೆನ್ಸಿ ಐಡಿ ಇಸ್ 111. ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ವೋಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇರಳ? ದ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯುಯೆನ್ಸಿ ಐಡಿ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ 1. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ವೋಟರ್ ಐಡಿ? That's all. We are just checking number of voters. This number of voters is present where? It is present in the trigger. That's what you can see here. Where is this number of count is present? Count is present in a trigger. Yes. So this is a trigger. But the procedure is not executing in my laptop, but it is working in the college system. It is a problem with the version. Don't worry. I have just explained you how to execute. So just take complete procedure, type complete procedure, and how to end the procedure? We have to end with slash. Then procedure is created. So what is the procedure created? Create or replace the procedure, because a checking is already there. How many times you want you can do, because replacing we are doing. So procedure created, and because there is a compatibility error, some problem. So then how to execute the procedure? What is the procedure name? EXEC. And what is the name of the procedure? You have to give page checking. Yes, this is one way. But because there is a compatibility version, MySQL and procedure is not matching, so it is giving me error. But this is the same procedure what we are doing. So this is how the procedures can be executed. That's the reason I was just explaining you how the stored procedures can be done. Yes. So this is what create procedure. So this I am just explaining you so that you can be practicing in your home and coming back for the next week. We'll try out in the lab session. Yes, getting? Yes or no? Yes, fine. Only procedures is left over with your programs. It is, I have explained, but execution part we'll do it in the lab, and rest of thing I have done from my end. And we'll take a break and we'll come back at 10:50. Now you have a break. We'll take a break. Before taking break, let me take your attendance. Yeah. So today's date is what? 12/11. Asta?
No.
Asta, last lab 29, you were absent. Abhinav? Abhinav? Aishwarya? Answer your present attendance.
Ma'am. Present, ma'am.
Amresh?
Yes, ma'am.
Anu? Anu? Last lab absent. Last lab absent, Anu. Arbaz?
Present, ma'am.
Arjun?
Present, ma'am.
Ashok?
Present, ma'am.
Benita?
Present, ma'am.
Bhargavi.
Yes, ma'am.
Bhavishya.
Present, ma'am.
Chaitra.
Present, ma'am.
Devmalai.
Present, ma'am.
Deeksha M.
Present, ma'am.
Deepika.
Present, ma'am.
Deepika L. MB.
Present, ma'am.
Murli Krishna.
Present, ma'am.
Gangubai.
Present, ma'am.
Gudia. Gudia. Harshit. Junjar. Kavya. Kishore.
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Kishore is present. Lata.
Yes, ma'am.
Manjunath.
Yes, ma'am.
Last lab absent, appa.
Yes, ma'am.
Manjunath. Manisha. Manisha. Nayana.
Present, ma'am.
Last lab absent, Nayana. Nilanjan.
Yes, ma'am.
Last lab absent. Nishant.
Yes, ma'am.
Pavitra.
Present, ma'am.
Maithili.
Present, ma'am.
Last lab absent, Maithili. Priyanka.
Yes, ma'am.
Pavan. Pavan.
Present, ma'am.
Akash.
Yes, ma'am. Present.
Rajeshwari.
Present, ma'am.
Rakesh.
Present, ma'am.
Ramya.
Present, ma'am.
Rashmi.
Present, ma'am.
Ravi.
Yes, ma'am.
Rizwan.
Present, ma'am.
Vishal.
Present, ma'am.
Savita.
Yes, ma'am.
Shruti.
Present, ma'am.
Sneha.
Yes, ma'am.
Spurti.
Present, ma'am.
Srinidhi.
Present, ma'am.
Srinivas.
Present, ma'am.
Sunil. Sunil. Sunil idnal.
Present, ma'am.
Last lab ali absent, appa. Vaishnavi.
Ma'am. Present, ma'am. Last lab.
Present, ma'am.
Illa pa. Last lab absent idiya. 29th absent idiya.
Ma'am. Present, ma'am. 29.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Mark martin, appa.
Network issue inda log out agirabodu ashta, ma'am.
Aita pa. Aakidini, appa. Aakidini. Aakidini. Okay. We'll meet again after the break.
Ma'am. Junjar present, ma'am.
Junjar, you ask, remind me. Okay. Let me mark it. Junjar. Yeah, marked. Anybody else? Harshit, Gudia? Okay, we'll stop. We'll come back after the break.